Hi friends, this is Gangadhar and you are watching Testing Shala YouTube channel. In this video, you will be learning if you are looking to join a software industry, what are the skills you should know in order to join to the software testing field or an IT field. I will be providing a complete details on what are the skills required, especially you are trying to move from any other field to IT field, or you are just coming out of the college and you would like to enter into IT field, then this video will be very useful for you guys. So first of all, let us understand why people normally interested in IT field or a software field. Why people really likes to move into IT field or software field is we get a lucrative salary. We get comparatively any other industry, software industry people normally get a little extra money and little extra luxury in the software industry. Hence, most of the people will show interest to move into the software industry or in IT industries. In this video, I will be discussing on what are the very important basic skills you should know in order to move to software industry or in IT industry. So first of all, so let us understand there are only two things you should know, two skills which are very much crucial if you would like to move into software field and IT field, which is technical skills and a soft skills. There are two skills which are very much required. One is technical skills, second is soft skills. So technical skills, which are more relevant to a role or a project which you are going to work upon. The technical skills, let's say if you are working as a tester, you would be required a certain set of technical skills. If you are looking for as a software developer, you would be requiring certain skills. Or if you are looking for a maintenance job, then you will be required to work upon certain skills. Or if you are working on a networking job, then you will be required certain skills, right? The technical skills is different for every job which you are going to take it in software industry. Soft skills, which are common across software field or an IT field. Are you getting it, right? The technical skill is specific to the role which you are choosing. In software field also, there are so many different verticals are there, different roles are there. If you are moving in those kind of roles, then you will be required a certain technical skills, which is dedicated to the your role. But when it comes to soft skills, soft skills are common across all the jobs or all the opportunities available in the software field or an IT industry. So what are the very basic skills? If you are looking to move from any other field to software field, at least you should know these are the very basic skills. The number one is a technical writing. You should be very good in writing. You should be, because you will be sending a lot of emails. You will be creating a lot of documents. Then the second one is this one, especially if you are looking for a software developer role or a software testing role, at least this is the very basic technical skills you would be required. At least you should know certain programming language. It could be C programming, or it could be C++, or it could be Java, or it could be Python, or a Perl, or you can name any programming language. At least if you know one programming language, if you are well versed on the overall concepts of an programming language, especially object-oriented programming, if you are well versed, then it is always very good. Then the third is, yeah, if you can see, right, the network configuration. These are the very common terminologies. If you can talk about Wi-Fi, we should know how the Wi-Fi works, because if you would like to work on at your home, then you should know what is internet, what is Wi-Fi, what is LAN, how you are connecting to the organization network, or how you can connect your laptop to some network. At least this basic knowledge you should have it. You should also know what is all about IP, internet protocol. What is your IP number of your machine, IP number of your desktop. You should know the cloud technologies, because these days everything is getting stored in the cloud, and we will also use lot of services from the cloud, lot of softwares also from cloud. Hence, at least this is a very basic skills you should know. Even if you do not know, you can learn these skills. Hardware. The hardware, you should be able to operate on different kinds of computers. The computers can be a desktop computer or your laptop or even in the mobile as well. These days, most of the applications are most of the mobile apps are sitting on the mobiles. Then you should be well versed in operating on the mobile phones. You should be well versed in operating in your laptop and as well as desktop. Operating system. So operating systems is very crucial. The most of the time people knows Windows operating system, and once you are well versed with the Windows operating system, the next thing you should learn more is Linux operating system, which is very demand in the nature, especially in implementing a software. Lot of different variants of Linux or Unix softwares operating systems will be used in the development environments, and as well as Solaris, which are more of an enterprise softwares, they implement on Solaris operating system, and as well as Apple operating systems, which are coming from Macintosh. The last skill you should well versed is a database management. So database management is a very basic skill, which is the back end of any software, because you are going to work in software industry or an IT industry, then you should be well versed with this database management, which is SQL or a Oracle. At least you should know all the SQL commands which are going to be executed in order to retrieve the data, how you can pump the data from using command line. At least some of the very basic skill set is required. And if you learn this database management, then you can definitely, you can move towards working in a software industry. Now let us understand, this is a one part of the story, which is technical skills. The next thing is very important and which is common across any role which you are going to take up in software industry or in IT industry is soft skills. Then let us move on and understand what are the different skill sets which are required in terms of soft skills. The first one is a communication. So at least you should be able to orally communicate. You should be able to orally communicate to other person. Have a good written communication skills. Especially in IT industry, you should be having very good listening skills, because you should understand what other person is trying to explain you. If you have a good listening skills, then you can easily grasp as much as information possible. So the next thing is organization skills. Especially in software industry, everybody works with not just one task. They will be doing multiple tasks every day. Every day they require to attend meetings. Every day they have to do whatever they assigned. Then they have to go and present it to somebody. Then they have to send a status report and so on. Based on the individual roles, he will be doing or she will be doing lot of various tasks. You should be well versed in organizing those tasks in a well planned manner, so that you are not going to miss any target timeline for any of these tasks which are assigned to you. The next thing is analytical skills. Analytical skills are very much important in software industry. Why I am saying here is because in software industry, every day is a new day. Every day comes with a new challenges, new issues from the customer, where you should be able to solve their problem and in a more creative manner. So that means you should have good analytical skills, where you should be able to identify the problem, you should be able to pick the problem, you should be able to identify the root cause of the problem. Then once you are able to identify the issue and you are able to understand what is the root cause of the application, then you should be able to fix the issue or mitigate that issue. So in order to do all these things, you will be required to have good analytical skills. Next thing is to be a creative person. You should be a very creative person, because in software industry, every day we create one or the other new things every day. And if you are not bringing a new thought process, new ideas, new things, then you cannot bring lot of value addition in any organization. Hence, they expect you should be very creative enough so that you can bring lot of value addition, lot of weightage things, lot of new things into the system. And they expect whether do you really have that kind of skills, which are creative skills. Next skill you should have here is learning skills. In software, the learning is never ending, because every day new technologies will come, new way of working things will come, then you will be required to learn every day, day in, day out. Then only you can survive in the competitive environment, because software and IT industry, which are very competitive and cutthroat competitions will be there. Next thing is, you should be a good mentor, whether you are a team lead or whether you are a manager or you are just an engineer or just a developer in a software industry, still you should be able to help the other team member in that project, so that people can depend on you. Whenever there is a help is required, you should be able to help them very effective way. Leadership skills. Leadership skills that is not just required for manager or a senior manager, no. So leadership skills is required for everybody in the team, because the lot of time we conflict each other, lot of time we'll have a lot of dispute when we are discussing and when we are talking. Leadership skills helps us to resolve the conflict among ourselves. Next thing is the flexibility. The flexibility is very much required in software industry, because this industry is all the time we get lot of unknowns, lot of escalation from the customer, lot of real-time issues from the customer. So in order to solve those issues, we cannot always plan certain things. Hence, people expect in IT industry, it expects at least when there is a need, you will be required to work in a flexible manner. You cannot be a rigid. I cannot say I cannot work Saturday, Sunday, or I cannot work on extended day. You cannot say I cannot work on extended hours. Because the software industry or an IT industry, it expects minimum 12 to 15 hours you should be working in a flexible manner, because they need to solve the customer problem as early as possible. In hoping you guys got an idea, I am hoping you guys got an idea. If you are really looking to join an IT industry or an software industry, you will be required this technical skill and a soft skill. If you really like this video, then please give a thumbs up to this video. If you guys are not subscribed to Testing Shala, then please click on subscribe and click on bell icon, so that all our future videos will be in your inbox as and when we publish our new videos. Thanks for watching this video. Bye for now. Take care.